हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन द सीरीज ऑन द इनकम टैक्स केसेस टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द केस ऑफ मधुरिता पुरी यूनाइटेड किंगडम वर्सेस डिप्टी कमिश्नर ऑफ इनकम टैक्स इंटरनेशनल टैक्सेशन। दिस केस हैज बीन रिपोर्टेड इन 105 आईटीआर ट्रिब्यूनल शॉर्ट नोट 66। द मैटर हैज बीन डिसाइडेड बाय दिल्ली आईटीएटी डी बेंच एंड द डेट ऑफ द जजमेंट इज 18th July 2023. As all we know that in the cases where the capital gain is calculated, there is a lot of grey area where the department as well as the assessee has very big issues regarding the valuation of the improvement of the property or the fair market value as on 1st April 2001. The main issue arises in all those cases where the properties has been acquired before 1st April 2001 and when the assessee sells that property. So, in that case, the assessee has to take the fair market value as on 1st April 2001. And the main issue is that on 1st April 2001, there was no circle rates. So the question of valuation of property becomes very ticklish, and the assessee do not have any choice just to depend on the valuation which is given by the registered valuer, which have been approved by even the income tax department. But the irony is that whenever the assessee comes with any valuation report, the department do not accept that, except given a very straight away and straight jacket reason that the valuation given by the assessee is very high. Sometimes it happens that the assessing officer makes the valuation by his own, by crossing all the laws of income tax. And even if they go for the valuation by the registered valuer, whether it is under section 142A or whether 55A. So whatever the report comes from the department valuation officer, that reports generally are given in a very simple manner, and they take the value which is far away from the fair market value of the property. Because the main concept is that they want to keep the value so that there is maximum capital gain of the assessee and the maximum tax is there. This is the intention of the income tax authorities. Same happened in this case. The assessee inherited a property. The share was 1/3. Apart from assessee, two other assessees also inherited in the same property. Those assessees also sold the property. They took the valuation report from the same registered valuer from where the assessee has taken the valuation report, and their assessment was done also by accepting the valuation of the registered valuer. But when the case of the assessee was there, the assessing officer said that this valuation is very high, I do not accept this valuation, and that is why he referred to the DVO. And where the assessee registered valuer has given the valuation of near about 3 crore, the DVO given the valuation of 1 crore. So there was huge tax liability on the assessee. And the main irony was that the assessing officer did not give any reason that why he has not accepted the valuation of the registered valuer of the assessee, and even the objections of the assessee regarding the department valuation officer report was not considered. It was the contention of the assessee that the special characteristics of the property have not been considered by the DVO, and the main contention of the assessee was that when the same report has been considered in other two case assessees, so the assessee cannot be treated differently. So when this matter was before the Honorable Delhi ITAT said that whatever the valuation has been done by DVO is not acceptable, and because the registered valuer report has been rejected without giving any concrete reasons, except by simply saying that it is high, this is not acceptable, and deleted the addition. So friends, even if the valuation has been referred to the DVO, the assessee has a lot of scope to contest his case. At the end of this video, once again I am repeating the name of the case. The name of the case is Madhurita Puri versus Deputy Commissioner of Income Tax Exemptions, and this case has been reported in 105 ITR Tribunal, short note 66. The matter has been decided by Delhi ITAT D bench, and the date of the judgment is 18th July 2023. Thank you, friends.